Okay, you all welcome to workshop technology subject. Today we are going to start the new topic, cutting tools. Okay, the first we are going to discuss about the essential properties for the cutting tool material, and I'm going to introduce some cutting tool materials widely used in industries. Then we are going to discuss how cutting tools are failed in machining. Okay, the knowing about this cutting tool is very important, because you should be able to select cutting tool material for your application, for your machining operation. Okay, to select a suitable cutting tool material for your operation, for your machining operation, you should know how to select it. Okay, how to select it, what are the performance of the different type of cutting tool materials. Okay, then various type of cutting tool materials are used in industry. So among these various type, only the few around the 10-12 materials are widely used. At least you should know these widely using cutting tool materials, properties of cutting tool these materials. Okay, that's why we are discussing this subject, and also we are discussing how tools are failed. Okay, how tools are failed. So what are the action to take against the failure? We are going to discuss. Then we are going to discuss tool wear, especially tool wear we are going to mathematically model. Okay, tool wear we can mathematically model. So in the first year level we are discussing tool wear. Okay, we are going to model the tool wear using the Taylor's tool life equations. Okay, then I have included the small video of this in this lecture also. Then go through the this video and let's move to the today's theory. Okay. Okay, today we are going to discuss a new topic about the cutting tools. Cutting tools. Okay. As a first subtopic, we are going to discuss essential properties for cutting tool material. Okay. As a subtopic, first subtopic, we are going to discuss essential properties essential properties for cutting tool material. Okay, the essential properties, first subtopic under the cutting tools, we are going to discuss the essential properties for cutting tool material. Okay, when discussing the metal cutting theory, I explain the basic requirement of a cutting tool. What is the basic requirement of a cutting tool? It should be harder than workpiece material. Cutting tool should be harder than workpiece material. Okay. Then we can identify the most important property as hardness. Okay. Most important property for the cutting tool material is the hardness. Okay. First essential property is hardness. First important property is the hardness. So what is mean by the hardness? Okay, what is mean by hardness? The hardness mean, I think you may learn in the material lectures, hardness. What is mean by the hardness? Hardness mean resistant to penetrate, resistant to penetrate or resistant to indentation, called hardness. Okay, how to measure the hardness? Okay, resistant to penetrate or indentation. Okay, resistant to penetrate to indentation is called hardness. Okay. Then how to actually you may learn under the material subject how to measure the hardness. Actually, how to measure the hardness? You may learn the Brinell hardness test. Okay, Brinell hardness test. Resistant to penetrate to resistant to indentation called hardness. In a Brinell hardness test, what you did? How to measure the hardness? Okay. The hardness test. Hardness test is a measure of hardness of a material. Hardness test used to measure the hardness of a material. So what happened in a hardness test? What happened in hardness test? Okay. In a hardness test, let's take, this is the workpiece. We are going to determine the hardness of a hardness work material. The material going to be test. Material. Then tungsten carbide bowl. Okay. The tungsten carbide is very hard material. Tungsten carbide bowl is used. Tungsten carbide bowl is used. This bowl is pressed on the surface of the material with the greater pressure. Okay, the greater pressure. Normally for the ferrous metal, when testing the ferrous metal, it use 3000 kilograms. Okay, for 10 second, this 3000 kilogram force is applied on a 10 second period. Okay, because of this force apply on this 10 second period, what happen? It forms this kind of mark on this surface. Okay, this kind of mark on this surface. Okay, the amount of penetration, the amount of depth of penetration, this dimension A is relating to the hardness of the material. Okay, A is relating to the hardness of the material. Okay, A is relating to the hardness of the material. Without measuring the A, we can simply measure this dimension B using the microscope. Okay, by measuring the B, we can determine the A. Okay, but we are not going to determine the A. If we can measure the B, we can read the hardness of a material from the chart. Okay, charts are available to read this the chart orally. We have the published chart. We just want to measure the B accurately. Okay, if we can measure the B, that means B is this is a sphere. Okay, this B length is proportional to the depth of penetration. Okay, depth of penetration is relating to the hardness of the material. If the material is very hard, depth of penetration is very small. If the, for example, let's take the two different materials. Okay, let's take this one is very hard. This is soft comparing to this material. On the very hard material, it produces small mark. But if the soft material, it produces this kind of larger mark. Okay, that means here you can see this is the D1. B1. Let's take this is the B2. Okay, if the material is hard, it produces smaller dimension for the B1. The material is soft, it produces the B2 dimension, larger dimension for the soft material, with the soft material. Then if we can measure this B1 and B2, we are measuring this B1 and B2 using the microscope. Okay, motion microscope. We can measure this B1 and B2 with great accuracy. If we can know this B1 value, we can directly read it hardness, material hardness from the available charts. Okay, this is how we are doing hardness test for a material. Okay, Rockwell hardness number, RC number. We are used to specify the hardness of a material. Okay, then this hardness is very important. Why this hardness is very important the material used as a cutting tool? Okay, why? Because in every metal cutting operation, very high pressure apply on the tool face. Okay, very high pressure apply on the tool face. Okay, very high pressure is applied on the tool face. Then to withstand for this very high pressure, it should be strong enough. That means it should be hard. Okay, that is the reason cutting tool material should have hardness. And also hard material always, most of the situation gives higher wear resistance. Okay, most of the situation hard material gives higher wear resistance. That is also a very important property in as the material used as a cutting tool. Okay, okay, then hardness. When talking about the hardness, the important one is not only the hardness, hot hardness. What is meant by the hot hardness? Hot hardness means some material can give hardness in a room temperature, but when increasing the temperature, there's a sudden drop in the hardness. Okay, that sudden drop in the hardness. That kind of materials are not suitable as the cutting tool material. Why? Because in any metal cutting operation, temperature increases. Now, when discussing the metal cutting theory, we discuss about this temperature development two regions, primary shearing zone and the secondary shearing zone. Now you know how temperature is developed. Okay, then because of this temperature development, temperature with increase of temperature, the cutting tool material should be able to retain its hardness in this temperature also. Okay, that means hardness of a cutting tool material should be retained in elevated temperatures also. That's why it is called the hot hardness property. Okay, hot hardness property. That is very important. Hot hardness. Some materials are hard, but it can't give the hardness in when increasing the temperature in few hundred of centigrade. Then we can compare this hardness property among the commonly used in the cutting tool materials. Okay, commonly used in cutting tool materials. Okay, let's take. Let's see how to vary this hot hardness property. Hot hardness property among the various cutting tool materials. Okay. Then we can, I will explain using the graph. Let's take, this is the axis of the hardness. Okay. Hardness. Hardness property in this direction, temperature. Temperature, hardness. Every material, in every material, there's a drop in the hardness when increasing the temperature. Let's take the high carbon steel. Okay. Let's take room temperature, 25 centigrade. Somewhere in here, hardness somewhere in here. Then when increase into the few hundred of centigrade, there's a sudden drop. There's a sudden drop for the high carbon steel tool. Okay, this is a type of cutting tool material used in industry. Don't worry, I will explain this about the high carbon steel tool later. Then you can see when increasing it to a few hundred of centigrade, around the 300 and 400 centigrade, there's a sudden drop in the hardness for the high carbon steel tools. Then next hard material is HSS. High speed tools. High speed tools can give is harder than the high carbon steel tools, somewhere in here in room temperature. So that, but it can retain its hardness better than high carbon steel tools. High speed. High speed steel. Okay, high speed steel tools. Okay, and here you can see compared to these two, high carbon steel tool and high speed tools. High speed tools, high speed steel tools can retain its hardness even at the elevated temperature. So compared to hot hardness, this one is the best. Okay, okay. Then let's take another one, carbide tools. Carbide tool, little bit harder material compared to the high speed steel tool and the high carbon steel tools. Okay, it starts from somewhere in here, then it is better than these two. It is better than these two, like this. Carbide tools. Okay, carbide tools. Then next one, ceramic tools. Ceramic tool also greater than, hardness is greater than this carbide tools. Sorry. There's a slight drop
compared to these material, there's a slight drop of hardness when increasing the temperature, called ceramic tools. Okay, comparing to hot hardness among these four cutting tool materials, ceramic tool is the best. Okay, if you compare these four, ceramic tool is the best comparing hot hardness. Okay, hot hardness. Next carbide, then next high speed steel tool, next high carbon steel tool. Okay. But not only the hot hardness, we have to consider other properties, other essential properties when selecting the cutting tool material. Okay, let's see next important property, next essential property for the cutting tool material. Okay, next important property for the cutting tool material is toughness. Second essential property toughness property. What is meant by the toughness? Okay, toughness of a material. I think you are in a material lectures, you may learn this toughness property of a material. What is meant by the toughness? Toughness means ability to absorb energy before it fractures. Ability to absorb energy before it fractures is called toughness. Okay, toughness. Then the toughness actually measured using the area under curve of a stress strain curve. Okay, for ductile material, for ductile material, we are having this stress strain curve like this, no? Sigma stress strain proportional region, UTS point and the fracture point for the ductile work pieces. Okay, ductile work pieces. For the brittle work pieces, ductile. Ductile work pieces. For the brittle work pieces, sigma. We can't see this, even we can't see the elongation, there's a fracture failure, very small. Okay, brittle material, ductile material and the brittle material. So then area under this curve gives the toughness property, it's a measure of toughness. This area under this curve is a measure of toughness. Use the toughness property. Toughness property. Okay. So that means the ductile material can give. Normally, the ductile metals having the higher toughness. Not all ductile material can give the toughness property, but the ductile metals can give, because this proportion also needed, this height also needed to give the higher toughness value. So ductile metals can give higher toughness. Okay, but here you can see the brittle material can't give the toughness property. Why this toughness property is important? Why this toughness property is important? Because in every metal cutting operation, impact load acted on the cutting tool. To withstand for, to absorb this impact load, material should be tough. Okay, otherwise material may subjected to a brittle fracture failure. Okay, to absorb this impact load, for example, if you take the multi-point cutting operation, milling operation, every engagement of the two, each teeth produce certain impact. Okay, certain impact. In each impact, this to absorb this impact, the material should be. Okay, tough. Otherwise, it may fracture, produce the brittle fracture. Then toughness property, among these we discussed previously four important cutting tool materials. So what are the cutting tool materials we discussed? This one, the ceramic tool, carbide tool, high speed tool. I'm going to compare this toughness property, how vary among these cutting tool materials. Ceramic high carbon steel tool having the highest toughness property. High carbon steel tools, then HSS high speed steel tools, carbide tools and ceramic tools. How the toughness properties vary among these four cutting tool materials? What do you think? In this direction, toughness property increases. In this direction, toughness property increases. Okay, in this direction, toughness property increases. The previously I explained, in this direction, what happened? Hot hardness increases. Okay, the two different directions. That's why we should have a proper knowledge to select the cutting tool for a certain application. Okay, toughness also important, hardness also important properties, but these two properties are in opposite directions. Okay, the high carbon steel, when claimed high carbon steel tools having the highest toughness compared to these four, then compared to these four, ceramic tool having the highest hot hardness. Okay, according to the type of application, we have to select what is the amount of toughness we need, what is the hot hardness we need, then we can select the cutting tool material. Okay, that's why we are learning these essential properties for the cutting tool material. Okay, then the next important property we are going to discuss is the toughness, hot hardness we discussed. The next one, wear resistance. Okay, wear resistance. That is also very important. There is the important property. This very important property. Third essential property. Wear resistance of the cutting tool. Wear resistance of the cutting tool. The wear resistance mean when machining, the tool geometry should not change. Okay, the wear mean the loss of material from the tool tip. Loss of material from the cutting tool tip is called wear. Due to this wear, loss of material, tool geometry may change in machining. It causes to poor accuracy of dimensions, okay, and poor surface finish, and also generation of built-up edge. So the for the cutting tool material, as a when using the material as a cutting tool, it should be wear resistance. Okay, so that means higher, if the material is a wear resistance, it can give longer tool life. So what is the tool life? What is the tool life? Tool life. What is the tool life? Tool life means machining time. Let's take the time axis. Two regrinds. Time in between these two regrind is called tool life. when the tool tip become blunt, when the tool tip become blunt, okay, let's take the after regrind, they are having the sharp cutting tool tip, okay. Then after this machining period, it becomes blunt, okay, it becomes blunt, then it has to regrind, okay. This is the next regrind point, it has to resharpen, okay, it has to resharpen. After this is the after regrind, we are in the sharp cutting edges, then after certain machining period it becomes blunt, then it has to regrind. Then effectiveness of the cutting tool loss when it comes to this position, this machining period, this period is called the tool life, okay, this period is called tool life. It is measured in actual time, or substituent is measured in the material, amount of material removed, the volume of material removed, okay. So in substituent is measured obtained chip length, okay. In substituent it is measured, tool life is measured from length of cut, okay. These are the measurement for the tool life. It's when discussing this lecture series, we are taking the actual time for machining, okay. Then if the cutting tool material is wear resistance, it can give longer tool life. What is the importance of longer tool life? What happen, number of regrind increases. If the tool life is less, that means our material is not wear resistance, okay, it is immediately wear. Because of that, what happen, tool life shorten, okay. For the entire machining period, number of regrind increases in entire machine with the shorter tool life. What happen, in each regrind, cutting tool have to remove from the machine tool, then it has to resharpen, okay. Then it has to mount on the machine tool. Then the most difficult one is it has to align with the previous work, okay. This is a time consuming process, removing from the machine tool, regrinding, then the mounting it again on the machine tool, then aligning with the previous work we are used to, okay. That is a time consuming process, okay. So it wastes the production time, so it reduces the production rate. So that is why tool life is very important. That is why wear resistance is very important when selecting a cutting tool material, okay. Wear resistance, normally most of the hard material can give higher wear resistance, but wear resistance, property of wear resistance not only depend on the hardness of the material, it depend also on some other properties also, okay. That means we can't say hard material is always wear resistance, that's not true. Most of the situation hard material can give higher wear resistance, okay. I think you will clear with this wear resistance, why it is important when selecting a cutting tool material, okay. Let's move to the next essential properties for the as the cutting tool material. Next important property is chemical stability. The fourth essential property, chemical stability. Okay, the fourth essential property for the cutting tool material is the chemical stable. That means chemical instability means it should not react with the work material or applied coolants. Okay, even there is a small reactions, even there is a small reaction, we can repeat it, accelerate due to the increase of temperature. In every cutting operation, every metal cutting operation, every cutting operation, temperature increases. Okay, we discussed how the temperature increases in previous lectures. Temperature increases. What happen if there's a small reaction? It becomes rapid, it accelerate, and it becomes rapid. Then it may cause to any dangerous situations. Okay, so when selecting a cutting tool material, the chemical stability also very important. Chemical stability also very important. It should not react with the work material or applied coolant, so any other material contacting with. Okay, then when taking the chemical stability, ceramic tools, ceramic and diamond tools can give higher chemical stability. Those materials are not react with the most of the other materials. That's why the chemical when taking the ceramic tools, we discussed the four different cutting tool materials previously. Okay, in this diagram also, ceramic tool is mostly chemically stable material among these materials. Okay, then these are the four essential properties. Four essential properties for the cutting tool material. Four essential properties for the cutting tool material. What are these four? Four essential properties. First one, hot hardness. Hot hardness. Second one, toughness. Third one, toughness. Third one, wear resistance. And the fourth one, the chemical stability. Okay, these are the essential properties. Essential properties when selecting cutting tool material. Then these are the four essential, but there are also other important properties when selecting a cutting tool materials. Okay, chipping resistance, thermal shock resistance, and the important one is the cost. That is also very important. Availability, cost, then resharpening ability. Okay, these are very important things. Okay, other than these four essential properties. Okay, let's see how these properties vary among these various cutting tool materials. Okay, vary among these cutting tool materials. Already you know, I introduced the four cutting tool materials. What are cutting tool materials I have introduced? The high carbon steel, high speed steel tools, carbide tools, and ceramic tools. Then we are discussing in detail about this cutting tool material and how the composition of this cutting tool material. Before going to this, let's see how these properties are vary among these cutting tool materials. Okay. Okay. Here you can see different while using cutting tool materials in industry for the machining operations, high carbon steel tools, high speed steel tools, cast cobalt alloy tools, carbide tools, ceramic tools, cubic boron nitride tools, and diamond tools. Diamond is the highest hardness tool, hardest tool. Then the second hardest tool is the cubic boron nitride tools. Then this one is the first cutting tool used for machining operations. So it is introduced in before 20th century. It is being used for machine operation. The first, this is the oldest cutting tool material used for machine operations. Then second, it is introduced high speed steel tools. Then high speed steel, why is the high speed steel tool? That because the high speed machining can done with the high speed steel tools. That's why this name is given compared to the high carbon steel tools at the time. It's the beginning of the 20th century this cutting tool has introduced. So then secondly, next introduced cast cobalt alloys. Then the carbide, this one is very important one. Today the 80% of machine operation done using the carbide tools. Okay, more than 80% of machining done using the carbide tool. This one is very important today. Most of the machine operation done using the carbide tools. Ceramic tools, the cubic boron nitride and diamond tools are available. Ceramic tool also use, but these three actually used for special purpose machinings. And also the high speed steel tool also widely used. Secondly, compared to the carbide tools, because the maintenance and repair work mostly use high speed steel tools. For the maintenance and repair work, mostly high speed steel tools are used. In a mass production, carbide tools are used. Okay, then later we are discussing the composition, how these tools are manufactured in this lecture also. Okay, in this lecture. So then this is the widely used cutting tool materials. We are going to discuss how the discuss properties and some important properties vary among these cutting tool materials. Okay, first property we are going to discuss, already we discussed, the hot hardness increases in this direction. Hot hardness increases in this direction. Okay, hardness increases in this direction. Hot hardness increases. Sorry. Okay, hot hardness increases in this direction. Okay. Then the toughness property increases in this direction. The toughness property of the cutting tool material increases in other direction. I explained it previously. Then the wear resistance increases in this direction. Next essential property for the cutting tool material is the wear resistance, that is increases in this direction. Wear resistance increases in this direction. Toughness, wear resistance. Then next one, the cutting speed. The cutting speed means the speed we can cut with using these cutting tool materials. Cutting speed increases in this direction. With high speed cutting application, the carbide, ceramic, these materials are used. Cubic boron nitride and diamond tools used for high speed cutting applications. Okay, in this direction, the lower cutting speeds application, these materials are used. The next one, thermal shock resistance. That also a very important property, thermal shock resistance. So against the mechanical shock, against the mechanical shock, that properties increases in this direction. Okay, in this direction, thermal shock causes the same. This increases in this direction. So what is called the thermal shock? Thermal shock means sudden variation of temperature. Okay, sudden variation of temperature called thermal shocks. When applying the coolant, I explained the temperature increases in the cutting area when suddenly application of cutting fluid, different thermal expansion regions are generated. Okay, because of this reason, fracture may occur. This is common with the ceramic tools, ceramic and this cubic boron nitride tools. That is common. Okay, that is increases. Sorry, here this thermal shock resistance should be increases in this direction. Sorry, this one is not. Sorry, can you correct this one? It's not the one. There is increases in this direction. Thermal shock resistance increases in this direction. Because the ceramic tool, when you show the ceramic tool, it's a higher heat resistance material. That means heat generated at the cutting point, not distributed throughout the cutting tool, because of heat resistance of the material. Okay, heat resistance of the material. So that temperature accumulate, the temperature increases in a certain area of the cutting tool, closely tip area. So that different thermal expansion is generated because of this different thermal expansion within the cutting tool material causes to fracture, generate the fracture. Okay, to the when generating the fracture, it causes to chipping wear. Okay, that the particle wise material removed from the cutting tool called chipping. The thermal shock resistance increases in this direction. The high carbon steel, these steel tools, when we take the steel tools, those are high thermal conductive material. That means heat generated in a tip area can transmit to a other area of the cutting tool material. So that means the heat temperature distribution is a gradual distribution, not like the ceramic tool is not accumulated to a certain area, but gradual distribution of temperature we can observe from these materials, ferrous metal materials. So thermal, it can withstand for the thermal shock better than these materials. Okay, with the thermal shock resistance, we can introduce another important property, chipping resistance. Chipping resistance also a property of a thermal shock. Okay, chipping resistance. So chipping, what is meant by chipping? Removing of material particle wise, chipping resistance increases in this direction. Chipping chipping resistance increases in this direction. So what is the chipping resistance? The chipping resistance means because of mostly because of the thermal shock, the cracks may generate on the draw in this way to explain the chipping resistance. Let's take the ceramic tool, ceramic cutting tool. The temperature accumulate in this region, but temperature that means heat accumulate in this region because of temperature increases in this region compared to this region. So that the uneven distribution of the temperature, thermal shocks may thermal crack may generate. Okay, thermal crack, very small thermal crack may generate. Okay, thermal crack because of uneven expansion and shrinkage. So then what happened when applying the when in machining, what happened, this particle can be removed from the entire particle can be removed from the
cutting tool
as a particle it can remove from the cutting tool. This is called chipping wear, particle wise remove from the cutting tool. So then in this direction the material can withstand for the chipping, but when taking the ceramic tool there is no chipping. Then the next, the important one is cost. When taking the cost, there is increases in this direction. Cost, diamond having the highest tool material cost. In this direction, the cost increases. Okay, these are some essential properties and also the important properties. How it vary the among these commonly using cutting tool material. When selecting a cutting tool material for a certain machine operation, you have to consider all of this. Okay, then availability also we have to consider. Okay, availability. These are the things, important things when selecting a cutting tool material for a certain application. For hardness increases in this direction, toughness increases, wear resistance increases in this direction, cutting speed, that means the speed we can give is increases in this direction. Then the thermal shock resistance, that is increases in this direction, resistance to thermal shock, chipping resistance increases in this direction. Then the cost increases in this direction. Okay. Then next we can discuss the properties of each and every these cutting tool materials. We are going to discuss the high carbon steel tools, high speed tools. These cutting tool materials we are going to discuss in detail. How the composition of this material, how these materials are manufactured. Then type of then if we take the carbide tool, there's a different grades also, T series and M series. The different series are available. So we have to discuss. We are going to discuss in detail about these cutting tool materials. Okay.